This is the Entertainment Buzz.
Further on in the buzz.
What we gonna do right here is go back, way back into time.
Sky, are you? All the respect and I saw like a flag, hear me now. It's about it. Dig it with us.
Entertainment Buzz are the real thing, man. Sight.
Yeah.
And now, our feature presentation.
Okay, we want to say a very special welcome to the E-Buzz. I'm DJ Bones.
And I'm Kishima Francis. Want to say big up to our sponsors. Big up to Coca-Cola. Taste the feeling.
Yes, and of course, here we go. And of course, we want to say a very special thanks to Worthy Pocket State, Rumbaugh Rum, Truly Jamaican. That's a perfect cocktail with these two sponsors, eh? You have Coca-Cola.
What are you promoting here?
No, I'm not just promoting a good drink. See, Worthy Park and Coca-Cola. There you go. All right, moving along.
We want to also say big up to our viewers on the internet at irfm.net. Remember, you can log on and watch us for free. Big up to those of you who are at home listening to us on the 107s. We need it on a car and a taxi wherever you are. It is the E-Buzz on the 107s.
We want you to follow us on Twitter at irfm_fm, Instagram irfmja, or like irfm on Facebook. Those are our social contacts. As a matter of fact, if you're logging on to us on the World Wide Web right now, you can see how powerful we look and feel. You cannot be poor with a name like Richie. That's one. And on top of that, I tell you, Agent probably is his agent because Agent got some food himself. Man, with a kerchief around your neck, I don't understand that thing there. No, you have to use the Michelle, you know, they got to hear you. Big up yourself, Agent.
That's it, Rasta Live. This is A to the G to the NT. Agent J Music.
Well, you can spell. We like that. That's good.
We also got Richie Stevens. Richie, welcome.
No,
when,
it's a Rasta Live, so I look what I go on there. You
know? No, I think that is a Rasta in planning.
In process.
Yes,
it's good to be here. Everybody listening, big up. Yes.
It's great to see both of you. Happy New Year.
Absolutely.
When I see nobody from the
New Year. Well, I tell you. Sure. Happy New Year to you,
Happy New Year to you, man. Big up yourself. I respect
in February, it is Black History and Reggae Month. And of course, you know, they want to hijack it, or they have hijacked a selection month.
Yes, I think that has taken the prominence. I think that has really been is the focal point now because
absolutely
the next week, that's the day, you know.
Well, yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
It is. Well, tonight, of course, we have an interesting discussion. International acts piggybacking on dancehall for gains. Several ways we could say this. We could also say
dancehall genres sampled internationally and discredited.
Right.
That's
so
the one on paper.
We're going to have a discussion at 9 o'clock. Joining us via telephone, we're going to have Dr. Sonia Stanley Naya.
Right.
In addition to Richie Stevens, and we know. Big up to Richie. Of course, Rihanna sampled Your Sail Away. And now they're calling it Tropical House. We did some research. We find out what Tropical House is and all sorts of things. So we're going to get into that at 9. But before we get into that, the hot topics, the Grammys. Congratulations to
Morgan Heritage.
No,
congratulations.
Yes, sir. Big up Heritage.
Yeah, big up. Well deserved. Well deserved, you know. And of course, today, you know, a lot of people don't understand the gravity or the weight of the Grammy Awards, how much recognition that gives you. So when you're recognized for your talent, especially in this category of reggae, we have to say big ups. Big ups every time.
Absolutely. Yeah. And you know, what I find interesting is that we have not had a female winning a reggae Grammy. I like that.
I think it's going to happen
soon. Come on, ladies. You know, let's do it.
They're going to do a Grammy.
Let's make it happen.
I heard there's going to be a nomination for a single out with, is it Gavin G and Kishima Francis?
You Bones, saw? Can we focus for
affairs,
one second?
Affairs of the Heart, is it? Is that what it's called? You know,
no,
something.
No, but on notes of Grammys, you must also say big up to Kendrick Lamar.
He
performed at the Grammys, and Assassin was a part of that track. It would have been beautiful if Assassin was on stage and just came out and did his thing, as opposed to hearing the track via CD or whatever they played it on. But you know, that would have been great if that had happened. That's something also we have to touch inside of our discussion a little later on. That collaboration with Kendrick Lamar and Assassin.
Yeah.
He won a Grammy for the album. The track is on the album. Assassin is featured on the album. So does this mean that Assassin gets a Grammy certificate?
Automatically, yes.
Yeah, it does.
Yes.
Yeah.
Does he have it? Did he get it?
I don't know yet. Remember, it was last night. So
yeah. Yeah, you know.
A bit too quick.
They'll present it to them officially on TV, but I mean, I guess all the work would happen after that in terms of where to
What would prevent him from not getting it?
No, man, he should get it. He's qualified to get it. Yeah. Just like Monty and Lady Sa from No Doubt.
Right.
Gwen Stefani, was it?
Yeah, No Doubt. Is the
Lady Saw.
That's something also we have to look at in the discussion, because here it is in one breath you're saying for international acts, you know, it comes across problematic when they get into or do dancehall. But if it's a situation where when they do dancehall entertainers are ultimately getting ahead as a result, like we see with Lady Saw and Bounty Killer.
Well, I can't wait for the 9 o'clock discussion, as you say.
No, I can't wait. Yeah.
Because there's so much to say. There's so much things to talk about. There's so much things to clear up in terms of how people are accepting what we're saying, how they're viewing what we're saying. A lot of misconceptions. Some people think that Rihanna is being unfair, and that's not the case at all. Rihanna is to be given a lot of respect.
Yes. Because she reached out to you to get permission. Yeah, she seek permission. Permission was granted.
So coming, right
up,
way.
Coming up, we have a lot to talk about.
We have a lot. You know, the way we can't wait, we all start knowing.
That's
what
I was about to say. I said, you people are very much preempting this whole discussion.
No, we are. Because,
o'clock.
I mean, we're in the hot topics, and it is a hot topic. So, you know, which is why we're talking about it. But other hot topics.
Popcorn pleads guilty for assaulting police officer.
Well, what happened back in November 24, 2013, Popcorn was preparing to leave the island when he was stopped by the police, who requested a search of his luggage. The entertainer refused to be searched and became boisterous, according to reports, using expletives to the officer. We understand that during the dispute, the unruly DJ used a Hennessy bottle to hit one of the policemen in the face, causing wound to his mouth.
I think that was what you call a true...
that sound true.
That sound,
I know. It just seemed like it's a story.
Here we go.
But what happened? Can somebody say kick out?
But seriously. That is a drunk leak.
He actually pleaded guilty, and he was fined $25,000 or 6 months imprisonment. And of course, one would assume he would pay the $25,000.
I think that is a very smart move in paying the $25,000.
Because they actually were contemplating going to mediation, but I guess when he heard what the terms were, $25,000 is a slap on the wrist in comparison to if it had gone to mediation, because it's a situation where the police officer could ask for more in terms of damages.
Wow.
So, I mean, I guess you have to be careful of the slogans that you take on, because ultimately you...
They can be held against you.
No, not even held against you. You live it.
You have to live it.
You become it.
A real thing.
Yeah, kick off.
I mean, if you go around and you say unruly and y'all talk to me, yo, unruly boss, what?
And I'm never sober.
Kick off. Yes, that's another sound. Come on.
Right. What's his deal now with Passion Minot? And is it Peter Morgan?
It's
good, though. In terms of, is it that she raised eyebrows with her congratulatory social media text to Morgan Heritage?
I don't know if it is good. I mean, in one breath, she's congratulating Morgan Heritage on the Grammy. And part of the congratulatory message was hashtag bad dad in reference to Peter Morgan. So what Peter was saying is that Passion has his number, I guess, alluding that she could give him a call.
Time and place. Yeah, link.
Well, even if a time and place when it comes to your kids, I mean, what she's saying, if there's any truth, it's not tan good.
No.
But he was saying that, you know, she has his number. Richie, can you like stop laughing and scratching your head like you?
No, man, me not. That's a look.
Yeah, man. Right, Richie, you're online. So
no, here is something else that is interesting.
Yes.
Movado and his former manager, Julian Jones Griffith. Yes. Movado actually blasted him on social media, accusing him of theft, claiming that the former artist manager owes monies to promoters for stage shows.
Mm-hmm.
Julian didn't just sit by. He shot back asking Movado about a $25,000 that he received from rapper Drake to build a library that was never built. So I guess both of them are pointing fingers. There's only one way to find out. I guess we're going to have to take this one before the People's Court, perhaps.
Them no man.
Big up to DJ Brian. I see.
Ace.
I was slick.
Sharp tonight.
Hey, fine. Hey, Brian, watch your hype, it or you.
But Richie, Richie and Agent, what do you make of this social media situation where just last week we see where Bounty Killer and Footer Hype washed their laundry publicly for everybody to see what was taking place on social media, exchanging hot wood, nasty jabs between each other. And now we're seeing a situation where Movado and his former manager, Julian, in a similar situation. Movado has since deleted the post, but not before persons were able to screenshot it and are sharing it. So him deleting it from his official page is kind of pointless because people are still sharing it. But what do you make of it? Especially like grown men having like a battle of hot wood.
Well, I think the most important way, or the best way to handle them thing is for a man, call a man by them phone and deal with it privately. Saying, because even this evening we're having a conversation about how it's easy for people to just jump out and disrespect somebody who they themselves admit that is the person that opened the door for me now and make me have all of them things that me have now. And then same one come back and I disrespect the person in the worst way. And me I say, probably the person who opened the door for them have some terrible ways too.
Right.
So this is a perfect conversation for a private setting.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
So I'm gonna really rate them thing there. I'm gonna support them thing there. None at all. I'm gonna read them thing there. May I tell you?
You know what is happening? People are in their private setting, putting out personal information
on social media.
On social media. Yeah. So because you're in the privacy of your home, you're thinking, okay, it's not private. We're seeing it.
I'm gonna rate them thing there.
And it, to me, I think it also puts a damper on your professional career.
It does.
Because
it kills it.
Here it is, people around the globe, they're looking at you to say, all right, I need Richie for a show. But then Richie did go tell Bones something about something. You understand? So it's like, you have
totally
to be careful.
Understand. You know, I tell you something. We've been going through these hot topics and we've been talking about what's been happening. But we have two very talented brothers in the studio. We got Richie Stevens. And of course, you know, Richie, the name, we love it. Yeah. And of course, Agent. Welcome, Agent.
Yeah,
music artist this week. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about yourself. You have a foreign look, so I'm going to assume that you.
Here you are. Who is Agent and how did you get the name?
And who's your agent?
Well, originally, you know, Agent is, change. Mm-hmm. As a change is needed, a change will come.
Yes.
So therefore, there's a force inside of this land right now which requires a uniting. I will want to bring it forward.
Mm-hmm. So you're saying you are that change.
We are the change.
Well, let me hear the kind of change that you're bringing. Don't give us something a cappella.
Agent, you know this. I got to reach in at you.
It's a cappella.
Well, we're not on rhythm, so you have to give you a cappella.
Well, I say we are the few, the last, the remaining, the dying breed. And I know that love is the only thing that we need. So love is the answer.
Yeah, yeah, the mix man, I threw on the reverb and the vice.
Talk to me a little bit about how you got started in music.
Well, initially, we got started back about in 2005 when we had...
And see, so you're getting your first lesson how to hold
the mic. Hold it, Michelle. Good. We can't hear you. Yes.
Big up yourself, Richie.
Don't come up the diaphragm. Never.
Never. And that goes not just from the microphone alone.
You kill the quality. Right. Damp the sound and you kill the quality.
That's it. And that is wide advice.
Bones, this is Evo's and it's not sex wise. Do not take it any further.
I'm sorry about it. But you didn't say diaphragm.
Go ahead, AJ.
The original 2K5, right? To the first release, Chakalaka. And that was my semi-dancehall culture rhythm at the time.
Mm-hmm.
And initially, we did start in New York originally. We came to Florida,
right,
which is where I currently reside. Okay. Right now, but we are from Maypin, Clarendon, Bucks Avenue, and all of these places, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, what I realize is that a lot of Jamaican entertainers are residing overseas, doing dancehall, doing reggae, but then what are some of the challenges that you have? Do you find that in order to get the recognition that you want, that you have to come to the hub?
You have to come to the hub. You have to come to the root and the source. So as a result, one of the major challenges that we do have is exposing the music in that regard. So yes, even this week, currently, we plan to do a mixed media tour, you know, throughout the island, do certain performances. Tomorrow, I go out front there, you know, with a step band And man, step by step, I got down the place tomorrow, man. And yeah, just like wisdom
one of the things I wanted to find out from you, the name Agent. A lot of people get their names from very different things. Some people is childhood friends.
Right.
Some people get it from, you know, somebody just, you know, a name that is a part of your birth name. How did your name come about? Where you get the name Agent?
Agent now is, I tend to can't fit not just about any situation, any circumstance.
Right.
With quite simple ease, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, we can't talk to you now and then just start reason with you totally different we are. When you do with my colleague them differently, that's how we get it. So, them always I say, yo, do you want a special agent? You know?
Oh.
You move that way, I move that way. There. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, yo, you want more reason with that sister in there for me and get it done. Or,
yeah.
You know? But differently, agent is all about change. And a positive change is what we want to instill in them youth here today, you know.
Mm-hmm.
How would you describe your musical style? You know, yeah, some people say that they're reggae soul.
Yeah.
Some people say they're just, you know, culture. Yeah. You know, how would you describe your style of
tropical
music?
Tropical house.
Well, my type of music, you know, is freedom music. It is Rasta music.
Yes.
We now refuse it. Original reggae music.
Mm-hmm.
That
right.
is the force we seek to unite again.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because we're the great ones before. Well, we're even greater, you know.
Do you know that the path that you have decided to take is not the easiest path? Are you committed, irrespective of what's going to happen? Because you may find that you're doing it for a while. Do you have a system, or how will you ensure that in taking this journey, you will not be discouraged or you will not deter from your initial course, mission?
So you have to stay the course and stay solid upon it. You have to surround yourself, firstly, with a good team, as we have within K-Extra Entertainment, as well as Running Rebel Production, all healing out of New York, with your boss, down in that corner, right? That's all.
Mm-hmm.
But
right.
And separately from that, to keep true to your course, you must realize that if you gather the inspiration from hand high,
yes.
you definitely have to maintain it that way and keep it perfect, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And so we are looking at this thing.
What are some of your future plans? Before we even get to that, I want to book Agent. How I reach Agent?
You can always get to K-Extra Entertainment as well.
They and have
how
a
do
number?
I? Or yeah, how do we get to them?
Absolutely, with K-Extra Entertainment, you can either touch with directly online, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that can be sent to HGTENT, Dre Music, and that's at Twitter, SoundCloud, yeah, all of them based
you're
on
there.
Social media. They are. You can also reach out to us at the telephone number, which you know, have to make certain that is always available for
yes,
us.
Yes,
and that is at 362-9571.
Well, I don't know, there's a different type of phone.
No, at the old time. You can't see it, and I have no touch screen on them.
All right, we're going to give our listeners a musical mix of Agent or music artist.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Agent.
Once upon a time, in a land far away, we were a people so strong, and long was the day, so we used to walk in arm, in unity, yeah. It was you for me, yeah. It was a land filled with caring, came from a heart of understanding, so we stand together in the land of the living, with thanksgiving, so listen to me, so we are the few, the brave, the last, the proud, the last.
Oh. Wow. You know, welcome back. And of course, we're just giving you a taste of our music artist, Agent. Agent, boy, you have a song there, do you know?
Give thanks. Then,
anybody tell you, say you sound like some of them Mali people, eh? You have the Mali sound there, you know?
Occasionally.
Okay, I think that's supposed to reach you.
You write your own material or you have a ghostwriter?
We currently write every unit by ourselves at this time. We are not, however, opposed to a writer.
To a good writer.
Yeah, yes.
You know, when I'm
Richie, it happens.
Richie sound like him out of a collab, you know?
No, Agent sound good still.
He does.
You know, and during the song, you ask him the important question, is you all right, them lyrics, them say yes, so.
Mm-hmm.
Eating up my youth.
You know, sound good.
Stamp of approval, you know, Agent. From the Richie, you know.
If it never sound good, people don't say nothing, you know.
No, you're not going to put a mute.
All right, no, yes. We got the big bad Richie Stevens in studio. Yeah. Richie, what's the latest? So many things happening with you. We know talk to us about the project, Sail Away. You did say that you're doing a remake. What's the latest with that?
All right, a remake is definitely on the way. I just put Assassin. Let me declare one of my all-time favorite DJ.
Mm-hmm.
I feel say Assassin is one of the baddest DJ from Jamaica. Saying, and you said something earlier that I called him up last night and we'll have about our conversation about it.
Uh-huh.
Can you imagine Agent Sasko walk out on that stage last night?
Mad.
Mash up, you know.
With the performer that he is and the talent that he possesses. It would have been a different day for reggae dancehall again.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But we must fight to get back there so that it become a natural thing. For him to be on that stage.
Right.
That's all I'm going to say.
Richie, we have 3 minutes, you know. We so reach the topic, you know. 3 minutes. You know, so Richie,
That's number one.
Yeah.
Yes.
Number two, mm-hmm. There's a song on the Sail Away rhythm as well.
Yes.
With Sean Paul. And I put it, I Care is also one of my favorite.
Great singer.
Singer.
Great vocalist, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Doing something for the ladies, you know, you have to big up the ladies. So we put her in it, singing a hook. To make it fresh again. So two songs will be re-released on the Sail Away rhythm, which put out from 1998.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So it's good to have.
So you're not doing anything on it?
No, well, I have a song on it
mm-hmm.
that I combinate with Agent Sasko. It's the same old song
thing. Oh, okay. You understand? Okay.
Right.
Yes. So that's pretty much, I'm not going to put out the whole juggling again. No.
Keep it fresh.
Yeah. But what is new with you? I mean, you rip up the place last time with Skatek.
Other than you're always looking young and not giving us the secret.
That's cool, man. But check this out now. Mm-hmm. I'm always doing things, and I have a project that I'm doing that I'm very, very excited about right now.
Yes.
You don't know about it. It's the first time I'll talk about it on here now. It's Richie Stevens and the Scanation Band.
Scanation Band.
What that is? It's myself and some Italian musicians.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
That are extremely, extremely wicked when it comes to music.
Talented, yes. Mm-hmm.
And we got together and we're doing this project where I'll be having them as my backing band.
Mm-hmm.
We have some seriously qualified. We have even a university professor of music.
What?
That is also a part of the band. So mm-hmm.
What does he play?
He plays a saxophone.
Okay.
And basically all the wind instruments.
Right.
But amazing musician. So, we're doing ska, not ska tech. Mm-hmm. Authentic ska music.
Authentic ska.
Because the ska tech was just a trial, because I like to try things.
Mm-hmm.
Never really work in terms of how the people receive it, especially in Europe.
I think it was good, your static. Maybe it's the timing.
I thought it was great here because.
No, when I say it's nice and entertaining, but for it to be taken seriously,
people
prefer the authentic ska music
right.
because it's such a big and powerful music that they don't need it to be diluted. You know.
Right.
So I kind of learned that and just come back and go to the drawing board. But I met this band last year when I was on tour.
Mm-hmm.
In Italy, because the Everybody Dance Ska song is a big song in Italy. That's why I was on the festival.
Okay.
Right.
What would you say to persons right now, Richie, who are listening to you speak and they're hearing you say you're going for the authentic ska song, but then the irony of it is that you're using an Italian band.
Mm-hmm.
And what do you say to persons who would you know, look at you to say, why didn't you go for like authentic Jamaican ska players then?
Well, first of all, the fact that they're Italian doesn't mean that the music is not authentic, you know.
Right.
Because a good musician is a good musician. They can play
no matter where you come from, right?
But back to what you asked me, why not some Jamaicans?
Exactly.
Why not doing it here?
Mm-hmm.
Many reasons for that. tell me when last you hear a ska song in Jamaica playing or ska being glorified. Because we are the factory of the music. There's so many genres that we don't pay no attention anymore.
Right.
But it is well celebrated elsewhere. So when I was in Italy,
yes,
and I was doing my show, my ska song went over very well. It mashed up the place. Right. But after me was this band that came up named Bagga Rhythms. Came up and mashed up the place.
That's a nice name.
With an entire set of ska music. And I was so impressed. After the show, we start talking. And then how this whole synergy start, they did a remix for my Everybody Dance that came out so wicked. And we start talking from there, and it led now to a project. So the real truth is, they are in love with ska music.
Wow.
They have a passion.
Yes. So it's natural for me to feed into that, because ska music is one of my all-time favorite music.
Right, right.
And you see that I've started here with it, and you know, I get some support, but not enough to really let it stay. People wonder, where Richie go with that genre, man? How long we done with ska?
It's one thing, people can say what they want, but when you think of a Richie Spice, you're not, I mean, a Richie Stevens, you're not just an entertainer, but you are a business head. your moves are strategic and calculating, in my estimation.
And wealth-oriented. I like that. Yes.
Yeah, but the truth is, I've been in this game for a long time, man.
So you know it.
From 84, how much years is that? 31 years.
Start a school, workshop.
So the real truth is, you just have to, and now I'm traveling the world, you get to understand the different taste of the different people and how they appreciate and accept
how they do business.
And
too.
Sadly, our music and culture is not celebrated in our own country.
How do you think we can change that?
By start playing it and support it right here.
Yeah, because we seem to be grabbing the American
There's
culture
a study that came out that about 70 to 80% of the music played in Jamaica. It's foreign music.
That's what I was about to say.
You understand me?
We can change it by lessening that percentage.
I'm not saying that we should not play foreign music.
No, because...
But at least let's create a balance.
Endorse our own. Can you sing us to a break?
Sing?
Can't have Richie have you
unless you want dance.
You have a new song, you know.
Sing it.
Do it.
Ever since you went away, every day is just a cloudy day. And I don't know if it's rain from the sky, tears from my eyes falling on my face.
Right.
And the rolling down my cheek.
You sure said that song then you?
No, when I said new,
I will be frank.
Before I said long time, you know, but guess what? It just a come out now.
It just a come out.
Because the selector and I want to drop it for them later on.
Why drop it?
Yes.
Yes.
Pick and stay. Soon forward. It's the E-Buzz.
Don't move.
When the sun goes down and you're stepping out, step up to go.
Coke with bubbles, bubbles with smiles, smiles with secrets, secrets with Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola with friends, friends with adventures, adventures with joy, joy with Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola with love, love with stories, stories with you and you with Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola with feeling, taste the feeling.
Welcome back to the E-Buzz. DJ Brian, you have us waiting.
That was
waiting for the track.
Once I get ready for split, and
I'm ready to do a cartwheel, you know, man.
Hey, want to say big up to our sponsors. Big up to Coca-Cola, Taste the Feeling.
Also want to say a very special thanks to Worthy Park Estate, Rum Bar Rum, Truly Jamaican, Richie Stevens, an agent in studio tonight. Of course, it's all about the E-Buzz. We go until 10. And of course, tonight's discussion surrounding the dancehall genre and how it's been sampled and discredited on the international scene. And I must tell you, should we play that clip?
We're going to play that clip. But before we play the clip, we are going to be joined online also by Dr. Sonia Stanley Nair. Dr.
Superstar.
Nair, if you're there, we're just going to ask you to stand by. We're going to kick things off with a clip done by a nerd writer. He refers to himself as nerd writer. He's from San Francisco. And he basically puts everything into context. So it is only fitting that we kickstart the discussion
nerd writer, Ivan
with this piece from nerd writer.
Yes, Ivan Pushak.
Okay, so what you're listening to right now is the relatively simple, deceptively bouncy beat to Rihanna's latest single, Work. This beat, which doesn't get much more complicated than this throughout the whole song, has a light, summery island vibe, which might be the reason why Rolling Stone, a magazine that has been producing music journalism since 1967, tweeted on its release, "Hear Rihanna and Drake's tropical house-flavored track, Work." Now, this caused a bit of a stir online because, of course, this song is not tropical house music, nor is it descended from tropical house music. Work is a dancehall song, a genre that has a rich tradition in Jamaican history. But a mistake like this is, I think, the perfect excuse to take a closer look at some of the recent trends in popular music. And we might as well start with this term, tropical house. Coined sort of as a joke in 2014 by 22-year-old Australian DJ Thomas Jack, tropical house is a somewhat slower tempo house music that often features pan flutes, marimbas, steel drums, and other instruments originating from the Caribbean or Africa to give the sound a more mellow, tropical vibe. Thanks to Thomas Jack, who, by the way, is now pretty much over tropical house, and other producers like Kygo, this subgenre swept rapidly across the world and right into the heart of the commercialized mainstream with mega hits like Felix Jahn's remix of Omi's Cheerleader. Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. And pretty much every hit of Justin Bieber's comeback tour. I'll take every single piece of the blame if you want me to. I think there's little doubt that these songs are surfing the tropical house wave. But even these mega hits, it could be argued, owe their sound to dancehall. In fact, you could probably say that about the whole genre. Bieber's Sorry, the instrumental beat of which is playing under my narration right now, is a perfect example. The addictive drum pattern at the heart of this song is called Dembo, which takes its name from the 1990 Shabba Ranks song. That's my... Shabba Ranks was probably the most popular dancehall artist of the 90s, and one of the first to gain worldwide recognition. The producer of Bieber's Sorry, Skrillex, has a long history of bringing dancehall into his music, and would know Shabba Ranks, as would his recent collaborator Diplo, who frequently cites the influence of dancehall in interviews. Indeed, another of Diplo's projects, Major Lazer, is explicitly a dancehall group. For the uninitiated, dancehall can trace its roots all the way back to the independence of Jamaica in 1962, after over 300 years of British rule, and the rise of ska music. You can go even further back than that, since ska is really just a combination of elements already found in Jamaican mento music and calypso music from Trinidad and Tobago, and both of these have their origins in West African tribal music. Ska takes these traditional rhythms and mixes them with the jazz and rhythm and blues that was popular in the United States at the time. Its emphasis on the second and fourth beats in the bar gave the music a jumpy feel, great for dancing, which is one of the reasons it took off in Britain in the 1960s as well. But as the post-independence economic boom in Jamaica sagged under rising poverty and rising crime, ska eventually slowed down and evolved into reggae. a politically motivated genre of music that would culminate in the global popularity of Bob Marley. By the time Marley died in 1981, reggae was a worldwide phenomenon. But back in the cities of Jamaica, musicians began turning to more up-tempo sounds again. See, one of the crucial developments of Jamaican music was the release of what's called B-side versions, which is basically the instrumental track of the song in question on the other side of the record. Jamaican DJs began singing and essentially rapping over these versions, and this is the precursor of American hip-hop, but it's also the origin of dancehall. Using new technologies, producers dubbed and distorted popular rhythms for DJs to perform over. The same rhythm could be used in dozens of songs. And that brings us back to work. The instrumental to this song, for example, comes from the popular Sail Away rhythm recorded by Richie Stevens first in 1998. This rhythm can also be heard in Beanie Man's Bad Man Nuff Flea from 1999, and Sean Paul's Fit and Legit. Trends in popular music are as fickle as the public is. Dancehall rose to international fame in the 90s, then faded. What's interesting to me now is that in 2016, dancehall seems to be rising again, but the connection is less visible. Its signature can be heard encoded into songs that have dominated the music charts for the last year and a half. But of all these artists, Rihanna is maybe the best ambassador of this sound for an American audience. Since as a daughter of Barbados, she lives and breathes this Caribbean influence and the long history it calls into cultural memory. I have nothing against new genres of music, even something as short-lived and perhaps mischaracterized as Tropical House. But I also think that it's important to understand the lineage of popular music. It has to be said that there are few cultures in that lineage that loom larger than Jamaica. Its popularity and influence will remain durable, I think, as long as there are great artists willing to put those rhythms to...
No, that's amazing.
That was a fantastic feature. Again, we say big up to Nerdwriter. That was really, really phenomenal.
Yeah, big up Evan Pushak.
And I want to say at this point, welcome to the eBuzz, Dr. Sonia Stanley Naya.
Hi, good evening to your listeners.
Happy New Year, Doctor.
And of course, you know, she's senior lecturer in cultural studies at the
University.
Senior lecturer of cultural studies at the University of the West.
Hi, Doc. Nice to see you and nice to hear you.
Hi, Bones. How are you? It's been long.
After a loss here, I'm going to talk to you.
Let's jump right into the discussion. In studio, we have Richie Stevens and we also have Agent, our music artist.
Hi, hello, Richie.
No,
nice to have you.
Now, what is happening? International acts piggybacking on dancehall for gains. However, with what we're experiencing now with Rolling Stones calling dancehall tropical music, this is not the first time, however, that reggae has been rebranded. We have seen it with reggaeton. Dr. Naya, why do you think persons are feeling this type of way now in comparison to then?
So let me answer your question by giving you a scenario. Where online do you find all of the rhythms made in Jamaica? Where in a book? Where anywhere?
Yeah.
I'm asking a question because there is something that we have not done as a people, the people who have created the 8 different genres of music that we gave the world in the latter half of the 20th century. We have been busy creating, but not necessarily busy documenting what is being created.
Right.
And that's something really critical because these contexts of appropriation, cross-fertilization, however we want to call them, we are partially responsible. They are examples to show us that we need to get with the business of our own music. And what is critical is that we don't see these moments of cross-fertilization and appropriation as wholly negative, because yes. if there is no cross-fertilization and appropriation, then actually what happens is music will die. Cultures die without that kind of cross-fertilization.
Right.
So the borrowing is going to happen. In fact, the Sail Away Rhythm, Richie was very much aware that this was being used in the Rihanna recording. Mm-hmm. What we must be able to do beyond the context of the borrowing is to be able to trace the genealogy of the music. Mm-hmm. And have that be audible, visible, retrievable, you know, in ways that people can understand the resources that we have amassed in the context of creating this music.
Mm-hmm. And to bring Richie in, no, because Richie, you have done that to the point where you are being compensated for your rhythm. However, how do you feel to know that permission was granted? Permission was requested. It was subsequently granted. However, your dancehall rhythm that was used is being called something else.
All right, let me answer a question that you asked earlier, which you said something about people piggybacking.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes, it's going on, but one thing everybody must understand is that whatever is music or sport or whatever it is, once it's lucrative, people are going to come into it.
That's true.
And I always say, I have no problem with different people from different countries coming into our genre of music or our culture. Because you know that I basically give gentlemen a start. So
yeah.
mm-hmm. that tells you something. I have no problem with other people.
Right.
And thing. Mm-hmm. But when a Rolling Stone magazine, who has been around from the 67, mm-hmm. doing mm-hmm. entertainment journalism,
yeah.
tweet a statement like that, and as you say, to call mm-hmm. something that is created from my rhythm,
right.
which Rihanna herself,
seek
give full credit and give mm-hmm. full credit mm-hmm. to me and to dancehall to
right.
call her song. She's excited about her new dancehall track
right.
that
mm-hmm.
was created from the Sail Away Rhythm that
right.
was done by Richie Stevens. She said to herself. So there's a lot of props for that
yes.
coming from me and Jamaica to Rihanna. Mm-hmm. But Rolling Stone now want to distort.
And it's not the first
and discredit that credit coming from Rihanna. Right. That is why I think this conversation is very, very necessary
yes.
to shed some light on it. Because a lot of people also say, boy, Rihanna, I'm going to try to keep the music. Justin Bieber, I'm going to try to keep the music.
Uh-huh.
Nothing like that. I don't think that's the issue here.
Right.
Because none
mm-hmm.
of those people call the music Tropical House.
No.
This is now the media. Mm-hmm. The people who can really spread the message out to the rest of the world. Mm-hmm. They are the ones that are trying to push this Tropical House thing. So what we want to do is clear that up. And clarify it, because I'm not authority. No musicologist, no authority on music, but mm-hmm. I'm a reggae artist.
Mm-hmm.
So it affects me directly.
And something I found today, Rolling Stone article mm-hmm. published September 8, 2015, mm-hmm. they made reference. Well, on your birthday, they made reference to Omi's remix.
Happy birthday. Dad.
Happy birthday.
They made reference to Omi's remix of Cheerleader featuring Felix as Tropical House, saying the song's laid-back groove and snow cone sweet melody has been dubbed Tropical House. So this is a repeat offense as it relates to Rolling Stone, who is a renowned publication that a lot of people look up to. So how do you think, Dr. Naya, how do you think members of the entertainment fraternity and dancehall and reggae industry in particular should proceed? Because this is a second time, and well, who knows, there's probably other times, but I found only one September 8 dated 2015
yeah.
and the tweet the other day. But how do you foresee us proceeding in terms of what we can do other than documentation of our music?
So definitely it lies within the context of the conversations we're going to have. And I mean conversations that are, you know, happening on air like we're doing now, educating our own people, because
yeah.
people might have seen this and not known the history of the transaction that took place in order for the recording to actually have that sound.
Right.
It is also going to be writing a response to the Rolling Stone magazine. It's going to be also in doing the political work, and I use that word very, very carefully,
mm-hmm.
the political work of having the Rihannas step out with their own statement saying this was not so, Rolling Stone.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
well,
part
one
of
thing,
the negotiation
I don't mean to cut you back, but there's
is
one
to find allies
okay.
in the business of promoting Jamaican music.
Yes.
There's one good thing that came out of this, though. Rolling Stone now retracted their statement.
That's correct.
Yes, mm-hmm. And say, that well, they are sorry. It's a dancehall song. Rihanna's song is a dancehall song. So the heat that is on them, because at the end of the day, they have to think about their credibility. And if they're putting something out that is so misleading,
yes,
you know, it makes a lot of sense for them to come and retract it. So give thanks to social media, because I tell people all the time that social media is bigger than CNN.
Yes, yes.
Richie, Kashima and Bones, yes. I want to pose an interesting question to you all. Uh-huh. Do you think that the classification of Omi's cheerleader as reggae fusion and this whole business of Tropical House now being used to classify the Rihanna tune and so on, do you think it's coming from a search on the part of these media houses, some musicologists maybe?
All right, let me answer that question.
To really classify the music, which is now taken on aspects of EDM, for example,
yes.
The use of instruments like the marimba,
yes.
You know, the in Omi's cheerleader, for example,
steel
very
drums,
clearly
yeah.
The sound of the Paul Simon inspired the trumpets there.
Yes,
I mean, is there something going on in terms of the musicological element that we need to take note of?
Yes, I was told. I'm not sure. That the whole Tropical House idea came from the popularity of Omi's cheerleader.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
Truth be told, cheerleader, the one that hit big, yeah. Is really a remix.
It is a
which
remix.
You can't really
it is a remix.
Look at it
yes.
As a dancehall song anymore.
Right.
Or as a reggae song anymore.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So they're looking at genre for it. Because right. It's not even an EDM song nor a house song.
What is it, a pop? Well, no.
Tropical House.
Tropical House.
No, they've called it Reggae Fusion.
Reggae Fusion.
And they have called it Tropical House.
I was told that's where the whole Tropical House thing comes from. Knowing that Omi is from the Caribbean.
Right.
And it finds something, which sounds logical to me. I'm not sure.
To add to that, I did some research on it, Richie. And to answer your question, Dr. Nayan, further expound on what Richie said. Yes, you are correct. Part of the research shows that you have Kygo, and Felix, who collaborated mm-hmm. with Omi. Mm-hmm. Now, Felix has been listed online as someone who is doing Tropical House. Mm-hmm. So his collaboration with Omi would definitely take Omi in that direction because that is what they're promoting.
Right.
Tropical House mm-hmm. is something that was born as of 2015. Mm-hmm. So they are trying to push that and make Tropical House happen. So, and if Felix collaborates with any other reggae act, Tropical House is their agenda.
So
that
that's
is
where,
what they're going
that's
to
That's where
push.
The confusion came in. And that is why it was very necessary
to have
for myself and Vegas and
yes.
Any Jamaican
right.
artist
yes.
to step up and say, because listen to this.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I've been in the game for a while, and every now and again, dancehall up on the rise. Mm-hmm. It's never consistent.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But what I'm afraid of right now is to see dancehall rising up again with no Jamaican artists.
Mm-hmm.
That's really not a good feeling.
No.
Again, we can't stop nobody from getting inside the genre. Dancehall has always been a very competitive music that can compete with any other genre and be million sellers. And we've seen it happen all the time.
Mm-hmm.
But more importantly, I think I read something on Facebook this evening when I was on my way down.
Mm.
And it says, I think it's written by Lyte Stanbury, and mm-hmm. it said something about Jamaican acts and producers need to get them acts together to start position themselves to capitalize on what is going on. And it's a good statement
mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
because when you think about the kind of production that is coming out of Jamaica now, I'm not sure if them are dancehall either.
Mm-hmm.
You know, them kind of more
well,
so like Tropical House.
Yeah.
So.
Mm-hmm.
And no, think about
true.
This. Now think about this as well.
And
think
some of them are tropical depression.
We are talking facts right now.
Stop.
Listen to this now.
Yes.
Rihanna, there is a little argument out that Rihanna and her team secretly came to Jamaica to do some research and check out. Right?
Mm-hmm.
They never did come and sample anything that is going on now.
Right.
So
mm-hmm.
that they go back to the 80s.
Right.
They went back to the 90s.
Right.
And sample My Rhythm. Right?
Mm-hmm.
I give thanks for that. And I'm happy about that. But I'm also concerned about the welfare of our young artists. Because there's absolutely no reason why we shouldn't see somehow we talent them
collaborating
and doing well in other thing. But I am afraid that what we're doing now is not really appealing to the international market, or else Rihanna and whosoever else would have come and really draw for some things from what is going on now.
Right, right.
So we really need to look at what we're doing as well as producers and singers and DJs, especially the younger youth them now.
I'm happy that you made that statement, and Dr. Naya, you can weigh in. When we look at even Joss Stone the other day making her mark on Billboard Hot 100 Top Reggae Albums chart, not only did she have the number one reggae album, but she was branded the number one reggae artist of the year 2015. Now, that in itself has to be an unsettling feeling for reggae and dancehall entertainers who are doing it. Here it is, you have a Joss Stone who literally, and it is what it is, piggyback ride on a genre, go on to the bill, did a reggae album with her followers. She's known worldwide and ultimately would outsell any reggae or dancehall entertainer. Now, what is that saying about us as entertainer? What is that saying about our industry? What is that telling us? What should we do? How should we tackle this type of situation? Because you can't say she can't do it, but look, she sees an opportunity, she wants to do it, and she took it.
Well,
so let me weigh in on that. You know, Richie said it, I said it earlier, we can't stop the boring. In fact, the boring is something that we need to encourage. What we have to make sure of is that our business is in order for us to benefit from the boring.
Right.
But let me also say that the quality of the music that's being produced now is also in question. This is the point that's being raised. If it is that the quality of the music is in question and it is only a busy signal, that is now dipping into the old catalog to mine the rhythms of the 90s and be able to appeal to audiences both locally and internationally. And I'm using him as an example here, not saying he's the only one. But he's been waving that flag for so many of these recordings he has had recently. What I'm saying is clearly, you know, like how Bogle said it, we have to go back to basics. We have to go back to basics to figure out what it is about Jamaican music that was appealing to the world in so profound a way that there are genres, not just reggaeton. There's Afrobeat, there is Bangra, there's Makossa, there are all of these musics around the world that have benefited, Kwaito in South Africa, that have benefited from that very borrowing. All right? Some, in fact, new genres created based on the influence of Jamaican music. So we have to ask ourselves, where have we fallen short in being true to ourselves? Where have we fallen short in being the country with what I consider to be the highest creativity quotient? I mean, no other place on the planet has given the world eight different genres of music in the latter half of the 20th century. And they keep saying that. I keep telling people, you know, I'm staying on message. Every child in Jamaica must know that. Because we must be able, at every step of the way when we are producing, whether you have a laptop in your house that gives you the ability to become a producer overnight or not, you must understand the legacy that you're a part of.
Can you give us a rundown of the
genres,
please?
And this is the point that Richie is making, I think.
I think you need to give a rundown of the genres, please.
Oh, yes, of course. So we start with bento. We go to ska. We go to rocksteady, reggae, dancehall, dub. We can talk about EDM because it's very much in the context of our own dub producers that produce the context for electronic dance music to be created. And of course, the one other that people never get, you know, making the distinction between reggae and this genre is Nyabingi. It's a completely different rhythm.
Okay. Right. And there's a reason why I ask you to name the genres, because that kind of leads me right back to my reasoning now, is that we're not here sitting down trying to have a problem or fight against what the younger generation doing now. But what we want to ask, the question is it working? Is it selling?
Right.
Is it appealing to people? If not, we really need to take a look of what we had before and go back to the authentic Jamaican style of music. Because that is what it seemed to me that the people internationally need.
Right.
You understand? Absolutely. And that is one of the reasons why the richer parties are so popular, vibrant and nice and, right, and full, and young people do pack them up and all these things. But I want to touch on a very important point.
Yeah.
You talk about Jazzstone earlier.
Mm-hmm.
When that was going on, myself and Coco T were on the phone talking every day.
Pick up Coco T.
And you know, so Coco T is, his song was done over by Jazzstone as well.
Mm-hmm.
And he and I basically agreeing on the same thing. That make the woman sing.
Mm-hmm.
She love reggae. It's no problem. She could have choose different genres too. I tell people this all the time. Any artist around the world choose to sing Jamaican music and talk Jamaican patois. We must give ourselves an and just be grateful because there's so many other genres that nobody not pay no mind. You understand? So I'm saying now, both myself and Coco T said, listen, the real problem here is that we're not getting the kind of support from our people that are just one or other people getting, so that we can be the number one reggae artist over those people.
Right.
Because it's not like she'd sell millions.
No.
She just do this, just do her
job. It's a regular amount of sales. So why? She is the leading seller.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the things that Dr. Nye was saying also is that we are the hub for all these great genres.
Mm-hmm.
We need to make sure that we position ourselves in a way that we benefit. And the benefit is normally chronicling what we do. A lot of times we just
all of this start from conversations.
Yeah.
You know, talk about things and not just and talk.
Yes.
We hope that what we're saying now will resonate.
We have to know who we are and that we are the
resonate with these people and everybody can start thinking because the music is on the rise again.
It is.
There's this lead singer from One Direction getting ready to come out and already announced that his first single will be a reggae track.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what are we waiting on? You understand?
Right.
You asked me about my project that I'm doing with Scam Music early, you know. It's forward thinking. I have to go out there with the music.
Right.
So whatever it's going to be some white, blue, yellow, or red people in the band.
Yes.
Doesn't matter. It's Jamaican authentic music we're going out there with. Yes.
That is important. Yes. We're on that
time. Big up on the Scam project, Richie.
Thank you very much. I'll give you a copy because I know it's your type
of
music.
Please,
have a copy.
Please.
And guess what? You never hear Scott play like this before. I'll take it to you.
That's marketing, Dr. Naya. Wow. Marketing right away.
So Dr. Naya and Richie and agents, in putting a cap on this discussion, what we have basically established is that you will never, you can't stop foreign acts from doing reggae and dancehall. That would be saying
and we
you
should
can't
never stop. And we try to
it's
stop
it's a compliment to
them.
Us.
Them
yeah,
up. Yes.
That is like saying Richie can do a cover of John Legend.
Yes.
Right? So we are not saying that. However, how can we better protect and hone what we have, dancehall, reggae music? How can we ensure that acknowledgements and rebranding, when that occurs, we are there in the forefront. Our people are being credited. How do we proceed, Dr. Naya, to ensure that this happens?
Well, you know, we've all been saying it, I think, in the course of the program. Yeah. We have to get our business of music in order.
Right.
We have to have knowledge of the intellectual property laws. We have to not succumb to the illusion that we don't need managers and we don't need accountants and we don't need lawyers.
Exactly.
We have to move beyond the arrogance. Some of our musicians, some of our artists are highly arrogant. Them are all my friends, them, you know, nobody take offense now. I'm just saying we need to get into the business of music. And that requires artists being able to create and create at the highest level of quality and leave the business of the music to the people who are, in fact, trained to do the specific jobs around the artist. All right? Part of what we must also do is become conversant with the fact that the Jamaican music business is operating as a small subset of an international music industry. And I'm choosing my words very carefully there. The international music industry, some of us don't understand. I was in a conversation today with Carleen Davis and others about the fact that many of us don't even know how the voting happens within the Reggae Industry Association for the Grammys. To be awarded. And yes, there are problems, whether they are spill or whatever it is. But I'm saying we must become conversant with that international music industry.
Right.
There are various aspects of that industry that we know nothing about. Not only that, things have so rapidly changed with the technology that we now we must understand that producing a song is almost an irrelevant thing because songs are being given away. Beyonce records an album and the album is being given away. Rihanna, the same thing. What I'm saying is that the song is a means to get booked for stage shows.
Yes.
The song is not the only thing that is going to give you a lucrative income. You must understand that there are different points in that business that you can tap into.
Right.
This is why I've been, you know, an initiator of the State of the Music Symposia, which have happened now for three. This is the third year we are going to be doing it in collaboration with Jampro and Jeria, making sure that we get a capacity building going, because part of what we must do is build capacity in the music business.
Right. All right, I tell you, Doc, you know, we need to have you on, but we need you in studio next time.
Yeah.
We need you, we definitely need
you. Invite me down and I'll be there.
The invitation is there for you, darling. I must tell you, we're going to put a cap on the conversation. We're out of time. But we want to thank you.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you so much. That is the great Dr. Sonia Stanley Naya. She is the Senior Lecturer of Cultural Studies at the University of the West Indies. Thank you so much for making time to talk to us. And of course, Richie Stevens, but I'm passionate. Mm-hmm. I tell you that.
Richie, any what cap you want to put on the discussion, you and Agent, before we go to a break?
Wow, what a discussion, you know.
Yeah.
These discussions are very, very important, and I'm hoping that it will resonate with some people. And as the doc said, forget about the ego. Because it's not leading us anywhere. A matter of fact, if you
ego
ask me,
is killing us.
I would say it got us in this mess.
Yeah,
the
ego
not
is
only the
us.
Ego alone, but the hustle mentality and not taking time out to understand the business that you're in.
Yes, yes.
90% don't know the business.
It's painful when you see some young artists operating on their own and calling shots business-wise. And I know for
business,
a fact that it will take you some time to try and to understand music business.
Yeah.
Because it's a very complex business.
Yes.
So when I see someone doing his own business at a young age, it just tell me that, wow, it's really a terrible thing. So let's pick some sense out of this conversation.
It can be good and it can also be bad, because if that individual will allow themselves to go to seminars, go to workshops where you can have a better understanding
Shima,
of it.
I will say to you right now as an artist, my darling, that it is not
who manages Richie right now.
I have management. I have my booking agent and I have my management.
Okay.
And everything is under good control.
And
you know what was beautiful today? Because about the Sky album, there's so much things going on with it. Because remember now, it's not just me. It's me and a band in a different country.
Right.
So there's a whole heap of dialogue going on. And my
team?
No, not my team. Just one person from a team. My advisor.
Mm-hmm.
We're having a discussion, a conference call, and we're discussing certain things and certain areas of which I know that I don't understand, because this is lawyer talking to lawyer now.
Right.
And it was just great to have that kind of representation. And people will take you seriously you operate like that. But if I was there trying to have a conversation with these people and they know that I don't really understand certain law terms and so on and so, then them take advantage. So it's a really serious, serious thing. You know, it's a really serious thing.
It has to be taken
seriously,
too.
And especially when you're dealing with these foreigners, please, you have to get proper representation.
And get your things on paper.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
And proper representation don't necessarily mean your entire family.
No, man. No family thing, man.
No family.
I want to give a quick one. There is an artist who I'm about to give some attention and try to bring them in the business.
Yes.
And a family member jump up and start present themselves as manager. So I asked them, so why do you want to be a stumbling block in his business? He said, no, I'm here to help him. I said, what can you tell me about music business? I'm here to learn. I said, no need nobody where I learn, man.
No,
need somebody with experience that can make
learn
things
happen. Learn and come back.
So it's very important, families. Just be family.
But in
the
same breath, you have many situations where entertainers have been so badly burnt by teams, individuals, managers who are damagers. We have had situations where veteran entertainers are close to tears. When they look and they hear songs that are being played and they look and see what they have in their kitty, which is nothing, because they have worked, they have spent their entire lives working and creating only to see nothing.
Kashima, we need more hours in this program to discuss this, guys.
I can tell you,
I used to be one of them artists there. I can tell you stories on top of stories what make them think they happen and what you can do to stop it. But I guess another time we can discuss.
We're going to call you back because we have to have these discussions.
Call you forward. And of course, we're going to do, we're going to take a break.
Oh,
right
hold on.
Now.
You're taking a break now.
Yeah, we're taking a break.
We'll
take a break.
We'll soon come back because we have a time signal.
I got enough to throw a rock stone after we know. Yeah, take a break now, man. Take
Richie,
a break.
I think we want you to take the time signal.
Yes, time signal.
Tap a top food hut for tasty, mouth-watering meals. See View Drive, Lucy. The time by Tap a Top Food Hut is
9:38.
You know what is so funny about that time signal?
Coke with bubbles, bubbles with smiles, smiles with secrets, secrets with Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola with friends, friends with adventures, adventures with joy, joy with Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola with love, love with stories, stories with you and you with Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola with feeling, taste the feeling. Coke with bubbles, bubbles with smiles, smiles with secrets, secrets with Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola with friends, friends with adventures, adventures with joy, joy with Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola with love, love with stories, stories with you and you with Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola with feeling, taste the feeling.
Since you went away, every day is just a cloudy day, and I don't know if it's rain from the sky, tears from my eyes falling on my face and rolling down my cheeks. Bring the sun, let me be your one and only one.
All right, I want to say welcome back to the E-Buzz.
Yes.
We got Richie Stevens, an agent or music artist.
And I want to big up my co-worker. His name is Dwight Fraser from the
Top Attack.
Is it the sports Top department? He goes, for mouth-watering meals, go to Top Attack restaurant.
No, Top Attack.
Top Attack. Phrase you're gonna say top a top, my youth.
Top a top.
You can't top a top. No.
Big up to our sponsors. Big up to Worthy Park Estate, Rum Bar Rum, Truly Jamaican.
Yes.
And
yes.
Coca-Cola. Taste the feeling.
Taste
Richie,
the, feeling.
The song that we were listening to a while ago, you actually sound like a younger Richie Stevens. What's going on with that?
Well, to be honest with you, there's a big history behind this song. I recorded this song 1992.
Mm-hmm.
For Steely and Clevey, a project they were doing called Steely and Clevey Plays Studio One.
Mm-hmm.
The same album that Don Penn, No is on.
Right.
And them classics there. But unfortunately, this song never make the album because they were waiting on Vin Garden to play back the trombone, which they couldn't contact him. So
right.
The album came out without this song. Mm-hmm. So right. I asked Steely and Clevey several times, what happened to the song? Tell me, just forget about the song. The tape missing with the song.
Right.
And it's just since 2016 You're playing back the tape and decided to put out the song.
Nice.
But I'm so proud of it, man, because guess what? This song has blazed right across the world. Mm. England, I feel it.
Awesome song.
New York, fire, Brazil, Canada, and even in Jamaica, see? So we give thanks. And this call for research, because still, you know, it's gone, but Cleavy is still here.
Right.
And he decided to do an album with me of the same nature.
Right. Mm.
Yes, so people can look out for this. Yes,
should
I'm excited
nice.
About it. This music is something that we can't get tired of doing. You know, I'm telling you about the Scare Project, and before that even come out, so we're working on another project. It's just so we do it. We love music, and to me, to be honest with you, I am working far more now than before in terms of recording and touring and all them something. There is far more now.
Mm-hmm. Why do you think that is? Is it that the market has changed in terms of how you have to operate in the business now?
Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. You see, at this stage of my life, I'm not in no competition with nobody. I'm just taking it easy and in cruise control.
Right.
So I choose my work selectively, and just do
what
I want to do now. You understand? So like how I don't have to be voicing on 10 rhythms. Different producers. I just work on projects.
Right.
You understand? So this is a project now with Cleavy that make a lot of sense.
Right. So you just work assiduously on that.
Because you know what? People are asking for it. Right. So that cool singing there you hear on the song there. We want some more of that. And Cleavy called me up and said, Richie, all of the radio people that we send the song
to,
them have a request, blah, 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 and we start working on the album.
Right.
You understand? Right. So you know it already, you know. We kind of love the multifaceted kind of approach to
very
music.
Important.
We do all different kind of style, and that is just me at the summit stage.
From long time. From long time. When can we look out at the album? That album you're talking
this
about?
This one.
Is it?
Probably to the end of the year or early next year, because remember now, so the Sky album coming out in May.
Right.
And after that, it's just touring all over the world. And one of the beautiful things is that because the Sky market is so big, we kind of did have some interest from last year, so we have places like we're going back to I'm going to Japan to do a very important festival this year, by the way, and after that we have Italy, going back to Brazil. As a matter of fact, I'm supposed to be in Brazil now, but due to the Zikvide, we kind of chill out a little.
No, chill out, man. That's it away.
A few of them were standing up outside waiting on you, you know.
earlier we spoke about the importance of social media. And you allude to that when you say that Rolling Stones actually tweeted the information, and as a result of what happened on social media, they have since
retracted that statement.
Now, every week we have our social media highs and lows. Here is Tony T.
Tony. Yeah, Tony. Anytime, Tony. Come in, Tony. Well, Tony soon come. She just come through the door. Say, Tony. What happened, Tony? Tony, quiet.
All right.
See Tony there.
Hey, I'm Tony T with the 411 on what's popping on social media with your favorite celebs. What's hot, what's not. Your social media highs and lows. This week, it's all about the Grammys. Here's your social media high.
Yeah.
The Reggae Grammy, of course. Now, officially Grammy Award-winning reggae group Morgan Heritage are still receiving a tremendous outpouring of support and congratulations from fans and members of the entertainment industry. International R&B sensation John Legend was one of the very first to send a quick congratulatory tweet to Morgan Heritage. Pictures and videos of the acceptance speech are all over Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. And over on Snapchat, We The Best Music hip-hop producer DJ Khaled had 4 video snaps, 2 with himself and Morgan Heritage, and 2 featuring Grammy nominee Barrington Levy. In these video snaps, an excited DJ Khaled said he listens to Morgan Heritage every day. You saw Barrington Levy's suit, right? It was dazzling, and DJ Khaled could not help but create a special cloth alert referring to Barrington as the Dapper Don. Major Key Jamaica, this was big. What's not? Social media wars.
Yo, you know, they're unruly boss. I'm representing
financial.
Here we go again. Dancehall artists and their feelings all over the internet. Dancehall singer Jay Mavado, in a lengthy, heated Instagram post, has laid it all out against his former manager Julian Jones Griffiths. The accusations are serious. Mavado is accusing Julian of owing promoters monies he collected for stage shows. Julian has hit back, asking Mavado where is the US$25,000 that rapper Drake contributed for him to build a library in Cassava Peace, because we are yet to see that library. You know, thief no love is a thief with long bag. I wonder, who is the real thief? In a short blog post titled No Retreat, No Surrender, Julian says a line has been crossed and everything is in black and white. So golly god, what else do you have to say? Julian still has his blog post out there, but you have since deleted your post. That retreat was just too easy. That's the deets on your social media highs and lows. I'm your girl, Tony T. Who will it be next week? Watch that post. I'm out.
You're out. And
Thank you so much, Tony.
Well, we're getting a big up yourself, Tony, a.k.a. you old ganga, you. Big up yourself, Tony.
We're going to open the phone lines now. You feel free to add to the discussion. Yes. Have a question, comment for Richie Stevens or Agent. The numbers to call are 974-5051.
974-5043.
Or 974-5079.
Right.
All right, the lines are now open. Agent, where can we see you perform? What your calendar look like?
Yeah.
I want to tell you, say, tomorrow night, you know, like we not said earlier.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I don't know, so that.
Where's the venue?
Tell us where.
Well, Mandeville Street.
Mandeville.
Yeah,
all right. Mandeville. We're in Mandeville, you're going to be.
You don't know a step by step HQ over there, you know.
All right, mm-hmm. Okay.
Free thing, I just roll up.
Yeah, man, free thing, roll okay. up. Buy up with something, them support the people. And it's a massive.
Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, like that.
All right.
Well, I
you promoting anything specific or special right now? Singles?
A specific right now, we the few primarily.
We've been playing.
You can
right.
also obtain that at your iTunes.com, Amazon.com.
So what about albums? Anything like that for albums?
Well, first release initially, you know, Push On Through is also available on Amazon.com.
Mm-hmm.
We're also
mm-hmm.
promoting. We want, you know, revamp some of the works as well.
Yes. All right. So in terms of, you're looking forward to doing any sort of collaborations down the road? Anybody you'd like to work with? I see you have a big star side of you there.
I would love to work with Father Richie. We are so much.
Yeah, man.
You think about it.
Yeah, bones, boy. You know. All right, the phone lines are blowing up, so we're going to go to the phone lines quickly. Buzz through calling you live.
Welcome.
Lad. Yo, Kashima, yeah. I'm born. Richie Stevenson.
Saba. What's
up, man? Yeah,
hear me?
Saba.
I damn house and just listen the old vibration. And me, I say, Africa, and bless up Richie Stevenson because he is one of the great substance in reggae music, you know? And just take you a little forward. I was at Barry Salmon's studio. And me and Barry Salmon collaborate a song by the name of Cool It Down. Mm-hmm. And Barry Salmon look at me and say, Saba, we need Richie Stevenson on this collaboration. And when Barry call Richie and he put on his part, may I tell you, it was really awesome. And I just want all of the listener, them around the world who are listening, know that Saba Tooth is a force to reckon with.
Yes.
Because if Barry Salmon and Richie Stevenson can collaborate with Saba, I mean, he's definitely something or someone to reckon with. And
bop,
just
bop,
to top,
bop.
Lad.
And just to top up. Just to top up.
Richie,
I want you to know that it is Cleavy and Steely that name me Saba Tooth. And I don't just get that name just so. I won a talent competition done by Arrows, and I get that name from Steely and Cleavy.
Big up yourself, Saba.
So,
what
do you
mean,
Saba?
What do you
mean?
Richie.
All right, thank you so
all right,
much, Saba.
Big up yourself, Saba.
I remember
Saba, big up yourself.
Richie, you are such an important substance in this business. You are a substance.
Big up Saba, too. Yes. Let's take this one. Buzz Saba, you call
like Saba.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes. Yes, caller, welcome.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Kashima, how are you?
I am good. How are you?
This is the greatest man on any radio, Mr. Universe.
Sir Universe.
Where is Ted Brown?
Me there, I'm Sav Lamar up.
Up.
Mm-hmm. Big up Sav Lamar.
Yes, Ted.
Come on, Sav Lamar up, because Kashiman Bones.
Big up.
Sav Lamar tall is all orange. So you know how beautiful that is. You know what? Beautiful. Mm-hmm. We got my MP, Mr. Dwayne Vaz.
Well, we're happy that they're planting oranges.
I didn't know they had so much orange trees down there. Good. Fruit's good for you, you know.
Orange
citrus. Citrus is excellent.
Vitamin C.
Yes.
Come on.
So, I feel with juice.
We have some, Mr. Ted.
Say, how is it, daddy?
Sav Lamar, we up. We up.
No, man. Sav Lamar, up, man. Sav Lamar, pretty like the club. Because, you know, when we have orange, you know, all that thing go.
Bone said well, orange is good enough. Vitamin C, good.
That's right, vitamin C.
Trust me, it's good.
But Ted, we have Richie and AJ, and yes, we don't really want to turn it into a political platform, you know.
Especially, we don't have a citrus sponsor, so.
Yes.
Political, you know, we have to talk now and then.
You seem to be focusing a lot on the orange juice.
And Richie is here. So, Richie, how are you, sir?
Yes.
Everything are going good, my brethren. Everything are going good.
Mama,
there, man. We just leave her a while ago from and Edin from Kingston come and watch you. And you don't know the buzz is an important platform.
You know, to hear Mr. Universe, hear him there. Richard, how are you, Mr. Universe? You're ready, you're upload, you know. Because sometimes when Nenin used to update, then I say, boy, we see you. Richard Steven really for IRFM. So I'm going to be really loud all over the place right now.
Yeah, man.
Right.
Big up my hometown. Big up my hometown. Seriously.
We have our music artist, Ted Agent.
Agent is in
and
here.
And Richie, we just want to say big up and keep the reggae banner high and continue. Keep Westmoreland and the general proud. You understand? Because you're a man from this part of the country.
Enough respect. And big up Godfrey Stewart for me too, because you know it's my school that. And
yeah, man. Yeah. You know we're going to have Mr. Godfrey Stewart coming up soon, same way.
All right,
and,
sir.
See, before you leave, can you sing one beautiful song from a Prime Minister, Portia Simpson Miller, please?
No, you're putting me on the spot there now, man, because...
Yes, thank you.
Remember. Thanks, Richard.
Thank you so much, Ted, for calling. Yes, you're doing the exact same thing, man.
And guess what? It must say before you leave. I'm God. Big up
yourself, right, let's Ted. Take this one. Bus through caller, you're live.
Welcome, caller. All right. So
Agent, you're telling
5
us...
5 minutes, you know. We don't have much time.
Oh,
left,
no,
so.
Yeah, that's true.
So, Agent... No, you see, you know, yes, anybody you want to big up, especially I see you brought your entire support team, management team. Big them up. Yeah. And of course, we're about
hold
to
hold on,
close
is
out.
Agent management all over us?
Look at the man.
Well, you think we up? This you think we up?
You came.
You think you're we across?
You're we across? You can't imagine when you get really big, a problem.
The man management ram up the room.
Tell us a little bit about your team, man, and big them up. And if you have anybody you want to big up, because we're in about 4 minutes before we close.
Absolutely. You don't know, I have to big up the entire Running Rebel family, K-Extra Entertainment, Dan Carlos, you don't see it, Running Rebel HQ. Mm-hmm. All of Queens, Bronx, Brooklyn, you don't know, everything between Bedford and Stuyvesant. Florida, you don't know, it's your boy to the G to the ENT, and always... I have to big up the entire Maypen family.
Yes.
The family out there. It's a man say, we can't live without them. We can't go on without them.
Right.
The unity and prosperity we are dealing with in this time, this life, and the next. It's a man say, on the tune, we the few. Do.
Right.
My fans, constant support. My love on them. 1,000%. See it?
Hi. Nice.
Father Richie.
How about you, Rich? Boys.
Yes, sir.
Big up.
Keep it up, man. They are sound good. Seriously. Thanks, big talk. But we just want to give thanks to the Almighty Father for keeping us going. Enough respect to the people supporting us. 2016 is a great year so far. We've got lots of music in the works. We just also want to heal up the whole crew that produced the song with Rihanna. Thanks for choosing that single. It's definitely
and we see you sailing away.
Definitely a nice vibe, you know, and everything is going well. So we just want to give thanks to the Almighty for that. See, yes.
Any uplifting words to Jamaicans around the world?
Yes, as we're in the political season right now, we just want people to understand how important it is to keep it all together and just remember that in a few weeks we'll be back to normal. So therefore, don't try and do anything stupid
to your
neighbors or your friends or your family. Mm-hmm. You know, just keep it. In one love, you know, make your decision, vote for who you want to vote for, but at the end of the day, let it be peaceful.
Right.
Mm. Be sensible in your thinking.
Right. Yeah. It's very important.
I want Jamaica for you all, you know. It's a mess.
Right.
So we must go on together.
Right.
Totally agree with
that. On that note, we say a big thank you to Richie Stevens and Agent for coming through the buzz and being absolutely early. We respect and appreciate your professionalism.
I remember Richie tired at punch and he still reached
and
time,
he got here early. You don't want to big up the people that will help you.
That's really true. You have to big up the walkers out people them.
Yes, yeah. Man.
Them come out and support straight. See?
Star,
and man
star,
like Neville,
star,
who's a bona fide Bridget.
No, man, that's Neville Lindo, who fixed window. Where is Lindo?
No, well, we have to big up the people, them, because yes. They really show some love, yeah. And we truly appreciate it. Yeah, big up the Rasta man who changed the wheel. See?
Yes. All right.
All right. Big up.
No, we need to get you a vehicle.
On that note, also want to say big up to our producer, Gavin Grant. Big up to Mark Hudson. Big up to DJ Brian. Big up to Errington Roberts, a.k.a. Cubano.
Cubano.
Señor. Hey.
And we want to say big up to Mark Hudson once again.
Big up to Tony T, or is keeping our social media connected.
Right.
And a big thank you to everyone who participated, Dr. Sonia Stanley Naya. Thank you so much. It's always a pleasure. And big up to our sponsors. Big up to Coca-Cola. Taste the feeling.
And of course, we want to say thanks to Worthy Park Estate, makers of Rum Bar Rum, truly Jamaican. I'm DJ Bones.
And I'm Kishima Francis. We're going to go out with some music from Richie Stevens and Agent. See you next week. Same place, same time.
We'll be back.
1, 2, 3, 4. This is the old times, yeah.